Good evening, everyone. My name is Dr. Mary Ann. We'll continue from question 86. Before we start, I would like to make some corrections to yesterday's video. Question 58. When I said the answer was lymphocyte, someone asked me why the answer wasn't lymphoblast. So the reason why the answer is not lymphoblast is because lymphoblast is immature. So the immature cells cannot carry out the phagocytosis function or graft rejection. So that's why it's lymphocyte. Then also, I said the CD8 cell is for graft rejection. It's also called the cytotoxic T cell, not T helper cell. The T helper cell is called CD4. Then the cytotoxic T cell is called CD8. Shout out to me. Let's continue. 86. A 28-year-old woman saw a physician because of infertility. So it's a woman, she's infertile. Under development of her ovary and her womb, disorder of the menstrual cycles were diagnosed. During the test of nuclear epithelium cells, it appeared that most of the nuclei had two bad bodies. The neutrophil nuclei had two drumsticks each. So as you can see here, you can also refer to bad bodies as drumsticks, and it's, you can check it in the neutrophil as I mentioned in the last lecture. So if you have two bad bodies, it means you have three X chromosomes because of the formula. How many X chromosome minus one will give you a bad body? So that's why it will be trisomy of the X chromosome, not Klinefelter syndrome because it's a man, and it's not Down syndrome because it's Down syndrome on the 21, Edwards syndrome is on the 18th chromosome, and Turner syndrome is absent bad body. It is 7. An 18-year-old girl, so it's a girl, has a body disproportion, wide shoulder, narrow pelvis, shortened low extremities, aliform skin folds on the neck, under development of her ovaries. So look at this, aliform skin folds on her neck. So I think it's the same thing as web neck. So your mind should be going to the answer already. During the lab analysis, neither drumsticks in the neutrophil or bar body in the nuclei of the buccal epithelium was found. Using the dermatographics method, it was determined that the ATD Palmer angle was equal to 66. Well, the provisional diagnosis is this, so Turner syndrome. The skin of a newborn is covered with a thick layer of keratinized scales. It looks like reptile skin. After the investigation of the pedigree of the family, it was revealed that this feature occurs in each generation. So it's in all generation and it is in male. What is this? What is the answer? Sorry? Oh no. Which of the below, I'm going for further myself. Which of the below mentioned biological regularities become apparent in this case? So they're asking you like, why that occurred or what resulted in that case. So it will be sex linked inheritance because we're talking about, you know, all generation and in the male. So that is why polyandric form of inheritance on the Y chromosome. So obviously Y chromosome is sex linked. So that's why it's none of the other answers, because we're talking about chromosomal disorders of sex linked. Sex like male. Three forms of Down syndrome. Okay, so before I answer this question, there's something called, what is it called? If I remember, I'll tell you guys, but Down syndrome has three forms, the trisomic, translocation, and mosaic. What it means is that when you take different cells, in Down syndrome, you're supposed to see 47 chromosomes, but in some cell, you can see normal chromosome number. So it will be as if some part of the cell is diagnostic for Down syndrome, while some are not. So that is a case of mosaicism. Translocation is where a chromosome, as I explained before, moved from one part to another part. So it moved from maybe the 14 chromosome to the 21 chromosome. You know, that's why it's Down syndrome. Then trisomic is additional. There was an additional chromosome on the 21 pair. Do you understand? So this is an additional chromosome translocation. The chromosome came from another chromosome. And mosaicism, in some cells, you're going to see normal, and in the other, you're going to see pathological. So that's the three forms of Down syndrome. So what method do you use to distinguish it to be cytogenetic, because you're trying to check the chromosome? I think I've explained this before. It's not pedigree analysis. That is what we just did earlier. It's for autosomal dominant and the rest. Biochemical is blood and urine. Study of twins, no. And population, no. A husband is homozygous by a dominant gene, which causes polydactyly. His wife is a homozygous by a recessive allele of this gene. So what they are saying is, the man has this disorder and is homozygous. So capital letter A, capital letter A. The wife is homozygous by a recessive allele of this gene. So she's not affected. So she has small letter A, small letter A. Which of these below mentioned genetic regularities can be apparent in their child as for their having polydactyly? So what this long question is asking you is like, which of these genetic or which of these law of Mendel will cause the child to have the disorder? So it will be the law of unit characters. As I explained in the last lecture, what is the law of unit characters? Parents make offspring. For them to have this offspring, they have to give their traits, and they can only give, you know, one. Like, these parents cannot give these two R. And this, the mother in this case, cannot give this two small r. So that's why the child has polydactyly, because the child has to take r from the father and r from the mother. And because this r is dominant, because they said in the question, the father is homozygous, the child will have polydactyly. So that's why it's B. Sickle cell anemia with erythrocytes are in the form of sickle. It is widespread among the population of some districts in tropic Africa. What biological phenomena is this disease based on? So we've done this question again before. Sickle cell is, glutamine to valine. Okay, so why is it not chromosomal aberration or chromosomal mutation? So it's not this, because sickle cell occurs when you have a nucleotide, you know, mutation. So because of that, the amino acid would change. So let me see if I can show you a photo of sickle cell here. So you can see normally, maybe GAG is supposed to give you glutamine, which is the normal hemoglobin, the normal shape. But in sickle cell, the A changes to U, so which gives you valine. So because of that, the erythrocytes, I mean, I can't go too deep into it, but the erythrocytes, because of this valine and the structure of valine, to change the shape of the erythrocyte to be sickle cell. So that's why the answer is gene mutation, because gene mutation, as I explained in the previous lecture, is, you know, mutation in the nucleotide. So self-explanatory. Parents with normal health, so the parents are not affected, have an ill son with phenylketonuria. But due to a special diet, he has normal development. What type of variability is this? So it's not the time you have to, you know, be Googling mutational variability. They already said that the parents have normal health. So I think what they're trying to say is the patient has normal karyotype, but they have a phenylketonuria son. So it cannot be mutation, because this phenylketonuria could have happened maybe due to some disease or something. I don't know in this case. So that's why it's be modification variability, because it has to do with when it's not inherited. So yeah, due to differences in their environment. So it's not due to genetic disorder, because you can see the parents are normal health. They are healthy. So it cannot be genotype or mutation. Combinative is both mutation and environmental. So it will be modificative variability, because it's due to environmental factors. Because if it's not the genetic disorder that is causing this phenylketonuria. So it has to be environment. 93. The checkup of an 18-year-old girl shows underdevelopment of an ovaries. So it's a girl and she doesn't have, you know, proper development of her ovaries. What can you see? They said there's neck of sphinx. So that's web neck. So what are we thinking? Turner syndrome. They even wrote here Turner syndrome. So they said, what changes in the chromosome quantity is this disease connected with? So from a previous lecture, it's a monosomy. So it's 45X0. 94. The analysis of the fetus amniotic cell for the presence of sexual chromatin shows the majority of their nuclei has tubular bodies each. What would be this disease? We've done this before. Trisomy of the X chromosome. Tubular bodies, so you plus one, three X chromosomes. So trisomy of the X chromosome. A proband. Proband means in a pedigree, the proband is the person. So now what is a proband? So in this, I'm looking for a very good picture. Yeah, here. This is the proband. Yeah, I think, let me make sure that's correct. Proband. Yeah, the person that is being studied on. So in this picture, where's that fine picture? Yes, in this picture, we are trying to, you know, this is the man, this is the person in question we are, trying to know what's wrong with him. So that's the problem. So he has three sons. His father, his brother and his father have this disease. His sister and two daughters do not have this sign. So what are they telling you? That the problem, so you see that in this question, they didn't tell you that, they didn't tell you it's in all generation, but you should know that the problem, his three sons. So you're trying to tell you that the father, his three sons, so it's in all generation. His brother and his father, they even went further to tell that his brother and his father again has it. So it's in all generation. The daughters don't have it, of course, because they don't have Y chromosome. So that's why it's polyandry, because this is also called Y-linked, you know, pattern of inheritance. 96. A man, okay, we underline that, with the problem of sterility, so it's infertile, applied to genetic connotation. During the analysis of the cheek mucosa, one bar body was found. Blah, 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 blah. So this would be Klinefelter syndrome because a man and he has bad body. A man is not actually supposed to have bad body because if a normal man is XY. So if you say one X chromosome minus one is zero, you understand? So, but a woman, two X chromosome, a woman, yes, that's correct. A lady, two X chromosome will have one bad body, but it's physiological. So a man having bad body is, you know, Klinefelter syndrome. In the prisoner syndrome, for example, in the last lecture, XYY, the man will not have bad body and he'll be very aggressive. 97, a healthy woman who had varia roseola during pregnancy gave birth to a deaf baby with normal karyotype and genotype. This baby deafness is a manifestation of what? So, of course, it has to be phenocopy. This question is a lot in croc and sometimes they like to twist it to genocopy. When we do the basis, we'll explain that. But the woman is healthy, and then she had this varia roseola. So I think they're talking about rubella here. So we'll do something called a torch infection. So those infections can cause the child to be deformed. So it's not really due to genetic disorder. So it will be phenocopy. So any disorder that mimics a genetic disorder, but it's not actually due to a genetic disorder. It's called a phenocopy. 98. During the analysis, of the buccal epithelium of a man, two bar bodies were found in each nucleus. Blah, 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 blah. What syndrome is this? So, of course, it's Klinefelter because it's a man and he has two bar bodies. So, if he has two bar bodies, it means he has what? Three X chromosomes plus Y because it's a man. So that's why it's Klinefelter. I've explained this in the last lecture. A girl with provisional diagnosis of Turner syndrome came for advice to a genetic consultation. Which genetic method can confirm this diagnosis? So I've explained this cytogenetic. Parents with normal phenotype gave birth to an ill child with albino. It is an autosomal recessive pattern. What genotype do the parents have? So it will be this. Why? Because I told you any disorder that is autosomal recessive, it means for the disorder to show, the person must have both alleles or both, you know, to be recessive. Like small a, like this. So if you remember that law of unique characters that we did, this A can only be gotten from one parent and this A can only be gotten from another parent. Like, this A can only be gotten from the father and this other A can only be gotten from the mother. You can't get this like only from the father. So they're asking you what genotype do the parents have. So if you look closely, the reason why this is not the answer for the father and for the mother is because if this is the father, the child cannot have this genotype. Why? Because as I explained before, autosomal recessive must have small a. So the child must get this A from the father here and this A from the mother here. It cannot be this, because if the father is, you know, dominant, it means that the child cannot have this small A. Do you understand me? So that's why it's this. You can also ask me, why is it not this? Because, of course, it can be this, because, you know, A from the father here and A from the mother here. But why is it not this? Look at the question again. Parents with normal phenotype gave birth to an ill child. And I explained to you before that when someone is homozygous for a disorder like here, it's more pronounced. When someone is also homozygous here to dominant, it's more pronounced than when someone is heterozygous. So that's why the parents have normal phenotype. It's only when there's a stress factor that a disorder will show. So that's why the answer is D and not E. 101. Pedigree analysis showed that the proband disease occurred in each generation. So it's a dominant disorder. Affected a relatively big number of siblings, both men and women. So irrespective of gender, what is that? Autosomal dominant. 102. A girl complained about what? Absence of menstruation. There is what? Short neck with typical folds, neck of sulfings, web neck. What are we thinking? Turner syndrome. 103. The parents of an ill 5-year-old girl came for advice to genetic consultation. In her karyotype, 46 chromosomes were found. Okay, 46. One of the chromosomes of the 15 pair was longer than usual due to joining of a part of chromosome of the 21 pair to it. What mutation is this? So it will be translocation. Do you remember I explained this in Down syndrome? That if a part of a chromosome moves from, you know, one part to another part, is translocation. Inversion is with 180 degrees. Deletion, they will tell you that, you know, something left or something was removed. Duplication is doubling. So that's why it's translocation. So it's a form of Down syndrome. 104. During cytogenic analysis, a patient was found to have cells with the chromosome number 46XY and 47XXY, or perfection. What did the doctor diagnose? So of course it's Klinefelter syndrome. Why? 47XXY. Why do we have this? It's mosaicism. I told you that when you have some cells will appear healthy and some cells will appear with a disorder. So that's mosaicism. And the last one is what? Trisomic. That is when you have an additional third one in the 21. But this is Klinefelter, not Down syndrome, because you're talking about XXY. 105. A 14-year-old girl has some abnormalities. So it's a girl. Her height is lower than that of other girls of the same age. Her neck is very short. Shoulders are wide. During the analysis, the lack of one X chromosome was found. So they are telling you that when they checked this, she was lacking one X chromosome. So it's 45X0. So that's why the answer will be Turner syndrome. from by method of elimination, Down syndrome, Edward and Patel, this is 21-18-13, so it cannot be something about X chromosome. Klinefelter is additional, not lack. 106, acaptonuria is inherited as an autosomal recessive features. Parents have a normal karyotype. Have a baby with acaptonuria, what genotype do the parents have? So this is the same thing in sickle cell. It will not be this because they said the parents have a normal phenotype. So that's why the answer will be E, A, because the child is autosomal recessive, so it has to be small a, small a. So 1A from the father and 1A from the mother. 107, a teenager with provisional diagnosis of Klinefelter syndrome came for advice with genetic consultation. What do you, you know, use to correct the diagnosis? So to be cytogenic, because you're trying to check the chromosome. I've done it before. 108, during the analysis of the woman's buccal epithelium cells, no sexual chromatin was found. What would this be? Turner syndrome. Why? They just wanted to confuse you. No sexual chromatin, no sexual bar bodies, no drumstick. So it would be Turner syndrome, because in Turner syndrome, you have X0, so 1X. How do you find your bar body? 1X chromosome minus 1 is what? 0. So that's why it's no sexual chromatin. 109. A patient has mental deficiency, short stature, Mongolian. Once you see Mongolian type of eyelid fold, your mind should go straight to Down syndrome. Then they said there's what, presence of trisomy on the 21st chromosome, so Down syndrome. 110, in a family pedigree, hypertrichosis, excessive pilosis of the auricle, that is plenty hair in the ear. The feature appears in each generation and is only typical for men. What is this? Why links? We have done this before. 111. During the cytogenic analysis in the cell of an abortive fetus, only 44 chromosomes were found due to the absence of both chromosomes from the third pair. What type of mutation occurred? So, I'm thinking it's E, nolisomy. Because they said what? Both chromosomes were gone. Sorry. Monosomy is Turner syndrome when one disappears. Yes. Polyploidy, I think, would be, you know, when it's three. Chromosome aberration is translocation, duplication, and so on. Gene mutation is on the nucleotide. So we're talking about chromosomes. So it's nolisomy because both chromosomes from the third pair, because we have 46 normally, and two have gone, as well as 44, so it's nolisomy. 112, sorry. By means of cytogenic analysis, the karyotype 47, so we have a trisomy here, XX, a female, 13. They now went on to say plural defect of the skull, extremities, internal organs were determined, blah, 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 blah. So it would be Patel because of this 13 here. In 1950s in Western Europe, women who had taken thalidomide spirifig bore a few thousands of babies under development or absence of extremities and transgression of the skeleton. What nature did the pathology have? So, this is history. This actually happened some years ago, 1950. There was this drug. This drug was made for, I think, to combat cancer or something like that. And a lot of people took this drug. And, you know, no one knew about the teratogenic effect. And because of that, after like some years, they started noticing that people who took this drug were giving birth to children who were deformed. So that's what happened. It was like a huge disaster. So they are now asking you, what nature did the pathology have? So the answer will be phenocopy. Why? I've explained this to you. The women didn't have any genetic disorder. They took the drug. Just like in the previous question, it was due to infection, so environmental factors. I told you, because you can see, they said the child was deformed, and we know most of these genetic disorder like Patau and the rest, when you give it to children, yes, they are deformed. So I told you, any disorder that mimics a genetic disorder, but it's not actually due to genetic factors. It's actually due to environmental factors. It will be phenocopy. In croc, if you see something like that, they put genocopy is wrong. The answer must be phenocopy. Genocopy will be due to genetic disorder. My baby has such pathology and anomaly of the lower jaw, and the larynx development is accompanied by voice changes resembling a cat's cry. Cat's cry. I told you, if you see cats cry and small head, what are you thinking about? Crudichat syndrome. So then I said, it is caused by what? It will be deletion of the short arm of the fifth chromosome. Well, I've done this before, but I want to bring your attention to this. It's short arm. Let me bring your attention to this. Look, a chromosome. If you look at this picture, this is the short arm and this is the long arm. So just in case croc removes the short arm and puts P or Q, which one is the short arm? The P. Which one is the long arm? Is Q. So that's why when you look at CrudiChat, if I write CrudiChat, 5P minus. So they're telling you that on the fifth chromosome, the short arm 5P minus, there was deletion. So here, P. So short arm of the fifth chromosome, or short arm of, or P arm of the fifth chromosome, 1.5. During the examination of the newborn, the diagnosis of Down syndrome was made. What is the cause of this pathology? So it would be what? Trisomy on the 21st chromosome. So easy. 1.16, a male karyotype is 47XXY. What are we thinking? Klinefelter syndrome. Then they went on to talk about he has endocrine hypertrophy, underdevelopment of the testes, absence of spermatogenesis. Indirectly telling you that the thing that's supposed to make him a man is not there. And he has endocrine hypertrophy. So I think they're trying to talk about, you know, breast development. The disease suggests what? Klinefelter syndrome. 1.17, a child ill with hemophilia has been born to healthy parents. But the mother's grandfather had hemophilia. What type of inheritance is this? Good. A child ill with hemophilia has been born to healthy parents, but the mother's grandfather had hemophilia. So if you look at this, the child has it, the parent do not have it, and the grandparents have it. So it is not all generation. So automatically, we know it is recessive. So autosomal recessive or recessive X-linked. Now, which of these will it be? In autosomal recessive, it is what? Regardless of gender. But in this question, I can see that they are specifying gender. How? They said, but the mother's grandfather had hemophilia. The mother's grandfather had hemophilia. So the mother, her father had hemophilia. So who is getting affected more here? The boys. So they didn't want to tell you that the grandfather got it from the mother. They just told you that the mother's grandfather had hemophilia. So from this question already, you can see that they're already going towards the male side. But that's why it to be recessive X-linked. If it was dominant recessive, they would have this maternal grandfather, or this won't be here. And if you Google hemophilia, hemophilia A and B, both of them are X-linked recessive disorder. So before even reading your question, hemophilia, I'm already thinking recessive X-linked, but of course, cross-check your question and your answer in croc. So recessive X-linked. 1.18, under the influence of gamma radiation, a fragment of chromosome was lost. So something was gone. What mutation is this? Deletion. Under the influence of gamma radiation, a fragment of chromosome has torn by 180. What is this, guys? Inversion. 120. Hope I'm not too fast. During the inspection of a girl karyotype, the shortened arm of the 20th pair chromosome was found. Shortened arm, so short arm, so P. What do we call this mutation? Deletion. A parent has phenylpyruvic acid in the blood and urine. Based on the diagnosis of phenylketonuria, based on this, the diagnosis of PKU was made. What genetic method is used? Blood and urine. What are you thinking? Biochemical. 122. In a maternity hospital, a child with numerous development abnormalities of the internal organs, such as heart, kidney, digestive system, was born. The doctors suspected Edwards syndrome. What do we use to confirm? We should be thinking what's cytogenetic, because we're trying to check the chromosome. 123. During the examination of an 18-year-old girl, such features as underdeveloped ovaries, so it's a girl, under she ovaries are not developed, neck sphincter, then they even told you Turner syndrome. What diagnostic method we use? What diagnostic method are we going to use, guys? Cytogenetic. 124. In a cytogenetic lab, the karyotype of a healthy man was studied. 46 chromosomes were seen in each somatic cell. How many autosomes does each cell include? So, of course, the answer will be C. Why? I hear you ask. Cell, I'll tell you why. Autosomes, ancestral chromosomes. Oh, they even brought it. So, what I forgot to mention to you guys is that, look at this picture. This is, so this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So, one from father, one from mother, one from father, one from mother. You know, this is, you know, I'm going to start going to meiosis. Now, these will be autosomes because they are not, they don't determine the sex of the child. Why this would be sex chromosomes? So yeah, is that that's why the answer is autosome, because they are, it's 44, because they're asking how many autosomes does each cell. Why is it not 22? Because they already told you 46 were seen. In a maternity hospital, a child with numerous development abnormalities was diagnosed with Portal syndrome. What do you use to confirm this diagnosis? So, of course, it will be cytogenetic, because we're trying to check the chromosome so that we can see that there's an additional chromosome on the 13th pair, like here. This is here. This is 13, so there'll be an additional one here. So that's why we're trying to check that. 126. In a genetic consultation, the professional diagnosis of Turner syndrome of a 14-year-old girl was made. What character does the girl have? So first of all, you have to check Turner syndrome. So it's, there's, you know, monosomy. So it's not, there's loss of one. So it's 45, tick, XO. No, this is the absent one. There's no Y because it's a girl. Tick. So that's why it's E. 127. A healthy woman, okay, she's healthy. She had viral rubella during pregnancy. She gave birth to a child with cleft lips, cleft palate. What do you notice? This cleft lip, cleft palate, I'm thinking patau. So now, she had rubella, environmental factors. Why am I explaining this again? She has rubella, environmental factors that cause her, the child to have a disorder that is mimicking patau syndrome, which is a genetic disorder. So, which is phenocopy. A baby has the normal karyotype and genotype, of course. These abnormalities will be due as it will be as a result of what? Influence of teratogenic factor. I've explained this. Or what? Phenocopy. Galactosemia is an autosomal recessive character. What genotype would healthy parents have if their baby has galactosemia? I've done this question again. So it has to be B. A, because recessive has to be small a, small a. So she'll get one from the father and one from the mother. Not this, because they said the parents are healthy. So if Crocs should remove healthy parents and put sick parents, you should be thinking about E. 129. The intensity of human skin pigmentation is controlled by a few pairs of non-allelic dominant genes. It was found that the quantity of these genes increased the pigmentation. Okay, it was found that if the quantity of this gene increased, the pigmentation became more intensive. What do we call this type of interaction? So I'm sure you are thinking it's between B or C. Why is the answer C? Because polymery means multiple genes, and I already told you that the human skin is controlled by a few pairs. The human skin pigmentation is controlled by a few pairs, so multiple. Okay, multiple, few pairs, so it's multiple of non-allelic dominant gene. I told you when multiple genes come together to make one skin, to make one type of, you know, phenotypic expression, which is the skin color, it will be polymeric. But pleiotropy is in the sense that one gene will have effect on so many things. Just one gene will code for maybe how long your hair is, how tall the person is. So if they tell you one gene has a lot of phenotypic signs, it will be pleiotropy. But polymerase is multiple genes for just one single phenotypic trait or expression. 1:30. You have 20 minutes to go. Let's see. Yeah, oh, we're almost done. Yay. There is this disorder in the family pedigree. It appears in each generation. Tick. And only in male. What are we thinking? Y-linked. 1:31. In a family of students from Africa, the child has anemia. In a family of students from Africa, a child with signs of anemia was born. The child died within a short time. It was found that the child's erythrocytes were shaped like a sickle. What genotype would the parents have if they had a light form of anemia? What are you thinking? If the parents have light form, they must be heterozygotes. So it has to be this. I think I've explained this. A child is ill with PKU. The child's parents are healthy. What genotype would the parents have? What are you thinking? It's the same thing we just did. B. 1:33. The study of the female karyotype shows that the centromere in X chromosomes is placed near the centriole. What do we call this chromosome? Okay, so let me show you that. So what is metacentric? I told you that centromere, yeah? This middle part. This one chromosome. Remember our first lecture. Metacentric means that, you know, you see the distance between here and here is the same. So metacentric, meta like middle. Submetacentric is it is almost to the middle. So you can see, but this is longer than this. Acrocentric is one is longer than one. You can see it's so pronounced. Then telocentric is it's at the end. So in the question here, they said that the centromere in the X chromosome is placed near the center. So it's not placed at the center. So what are we thinking? Submetacentric. Metacentric is at the center. Telocentric is at the edge. And acrocentric is, you know, not even close to the center, that they are unequal. So this subacrocentric is nothing. Doing a pedigree analysis of the family with such an inherited. Does anybody want to take a photo? Please, if you did not take a photo, you can take a photo now. A screenshot. Okay, let's move on. 1:34. Doing the pedigree analysis of a family with such an inherited pathology as transgression of enamel formation. It was found that the disease appeared in each generation. So it's a dominant tick. It is inherited by daughters from fathers. So when I say it was dominant, it's between dominant X and dominant autosomal B. But what did they say here? It is inherited by daughters from father. So what that is what? Dominant X-linked. If it's sons from mothers, is what? X-linked recessive. Sons from fathers, Y-linked. 1:35, cats cry. What are we thinking? Patau syndrome. This disease as a result of what? Deletion of the short arm, or what? Deletion of P arm of the fifth chromosome. 1:36. Endemic goiter is widespread among Transcarpathian population due to iron deficiency in food. What form of variability in this case is this case based on? So the answer will be B. Why? Modificative variability. What did I tell you? When something is caused by the environment, it's what? Modificative or no, it's not phenotypic, it's modificative in this case. It's not mutation, that's gene. It's not community, because community is both gene and environment. Hereditary is gene. For something to be hereditary, it has to be in the, you know, genetic makeup. And it's not genotypic because same thing, gene. So that's why it's modification. 1:37. A sick child has disturbance of lipid exchange, which is accompanied by the increase of lipid concentration in the blood serum and the accumulation of a substance in the nerve cell. What some dysfunction of higher nervous system also presents. What hereditary disorder is this? So of course it's Tay-Sachs. It's not Edward that we have ruled that out. Phenylketonuria is not about lipids. It's about C-ketone. So you should just remove that. Marfan syndrome, we did earlier, is a connective tissue disorder. Hemophilia is blood. So By method of elimination, we're left with what? TESAC. So if you should, you know, I cannot tell you everything, so you should study on TESAC or lysosomal storage disease or lipid storage disease. Last one is the part anatomic inspection of a newborn, The part anatomic inspection of a newborn boy's dead body showed the following abnormalities: polydactyly, macrocephaly, cleft lip, cleft palate. What are we thinking? Patau. These symptoms are typical of Patau syndrome. What is this? Trisomy of the 13th chromosome. Crude chart is what cats cry. So we move on to the next section. Let me see how long this is. So we're going to just do, I don't know if I should do this or should just end this lecture. We will finish this in the next one. 32. Yeah, we will. It's 1 hour. We'll spend 1 hour. Okay, so we're going to, we are in protozoa now, my favorite section. I'm going to show you a photo. Yeah, so let's start. Take a photo, very important. So let's start with Balatidimum. I'm just going to tell you the key things you should know and what you should just look for. Once you've seen it, bam, take your answer. Balatidimum coli. It has, you know, in the morphology, macro and micronucleus. If the crop talks about, you know, a protozoa having a lot of cilia around the body, two contractile vacuole, we're thinking about Balatidimum coli. It has two forms, the cyst and the trophozyte. The cyst is the infective or diagnostic stage. Infective and diagnostic stage, that's infective when you can get infected with this disease, and diagnostic when you can, you know, say, okay, I've diagnosed this, this is Balatidimum coli. And the mature form is the trophozoite, and they do not invade the bowel. You should note that if Kroc talk about some protozoa in the colon and sigmoid, like in the large intestine region, it is Balatidimum. These points will be important when we get to lambda intestinalis. E. coli. You can read this on your own. What are the key things you need to focus on? It's the same thing as Entamoeba coli, Entamoeba histolytica. What's the difference? Because Kroc likes to love to ask this. E. coli has 8 nuclei. In the, like the cysts, 8 nuclei. The cyst of E. histolytica has 4 nuclei. What are the key things you need to focus on? Flax-shaped ulcer. So this E. coli, Entamoeba histolytica and E. coli penetrates the intestine and cause dysentery, like blood and stool, watery stool, because you know inflammatory reaction due to the invasion and everything. So that's the key things you need to know. E. gingivalis, I forgot to tell you this. Also, Kroc will love to ask which protozoa, you know, when you look at it, it's red blood cell. So it will be the E. coli, because it can never be Balatidimum because they don't invade. So where would they see the red blood cell from? But E. coli invades and they will find red blood cell to eat. E. gingivalis, they eat white blood cell and they do not form cysts. And it's on the, you know, gingiva, teeth and oral cavity. Lambda intestinalis, the cyst has 4 nuclei, just as E. coli. However, on the trophozoites, very important, 4 pairs, so 8 flagella. Why am I telling you this? Because if you notice, pear-shaped, they are pear-shaped, they have 4 pairs of flagella, and they are mostly invading the intestine. But Trichomonas vaginalis is also pear-shaped, but if you notice, it's 4 flagella, not 4 pairs of flagella, just that one word, different answer. So don't make that mistake. So in Trichomonas vaginalis, another key thing is, men are asymptomatic. Men don't show signs and symptoms. But when, you know, they go and do whatever they want to go and do, and the women, you know, catch it, they show symptoms. Foul-smelling green discharge. That's why I wrote here, this is female and this is male. So that's why if a woman comes to you as a doctor and she has this disorder, this disease, you also have to treat the man. It's in Kroc. Don't go and say, treat the woman. Treat the man. Very important, because if you treat the woman, the woman can go and get it again from the man. So now that we are done with that, let's move on to the second photo. What's the time? 10 minutes, yes, I'm there to finish it. Yeah, this. The next one is take a photo too. These are just key points, so you don't have to read textbook. African trypanosomiasis, or what? Sleeping sickness, written here. What is the infective stage? Bite of cystic fly. What is the morphology? Spindle undulating membrane. One polar flagella. How many flagella does Lambert intestinalis has? 4 pairs. Trichomonas vaginalis, 4. Sleeping sickness is what does African trypanosomiasis, one polar flagella. Don't go and get confused and be like, oh, cystic fly is a fly now. It does not have flagella. No. Cystic fly carries the protozoa. So when you check, you know, what the cystic fly is biting and infecting us with, that's what it looks like. It has a spindle undulating membrane, one polar flagella. And this is key. If they tell you that when they check the morphology, the cytoplasm is blue and the nucleus is red, African trypanosomiasis. Also, we have the American or South American trypanosomiasis, which is called Chagas disease. This one is by T. cruzi. It's also called T. cruzi. And it's not cystic fly. It is the kissing bug or triatome bug. Why is it called kissing bug? Because it loves to bite around the lips and, yeah, you get it now. Leishmaniasis is the vector is sand fly. What's the morphology? It has flagella, but notice that there's no undulating membrane. And they don't really ask the morphology of this. What they mostly focus on is the two types. You have the visceral and the cutaneous. In the visceral, it's also called color azar. Croc loves to do this a lot. They will change the name. Dum-dum fever, black fever. And it's mostly in Asian countries like India and the rest. Cutaneous is on the skin. So if they talk about, you know, the organs being affected and by sandfly, it's visceral. They talk about the skin, it's cutaneous leishmaniasis. Toxoplasma, the infective stage is the oocyte. Important to know that cat is the final host and human is the intermediate host. The diagnosis is blood. That's all you should know about it. What else you should know about is that sometimes it is so that if a woman gets it when she's pregnant, she can give birth to a mentally impaired child or the child who's looking like Kwashoko, something like, not like Kwashoko, like, what's that word? Disfigured child, yes. Plasmodium, which is our malaria. So, where's my video? So, what's our time? Yes, I just want to finish the lecture. So, I'm going to show you this video. You can watch it on your spare time, but I want to talk about the life cycle of malaria because it's important. So, and also, there are two stages. There's the sexual stage of the malaria life cycle. It occurs in the mosquito, not us. Why? What is the sexual stage of sexual reproduction? It means like where the mature or the infective protozoa is being formed. So it is formed in the mosquito Anopheles. That's why it's a definite host. A sexual reproduction, or here is there's no mature form being formed here, and it's not the place. So that's why we're the intermediate host. The next stage is, so we're going to do the asexual reproduction. So in man, so what happens is when the mosquito bites a human, she injects protozoite. So this is the infective stage. This is protozoite. Write that down, protozoite, infective stage. So what happens next is that the protozoite goes and infects the liver cell. This is known as the exoerythrocytic cycle of the plasmodium life cycle. You get it? Exoerythrocyte, because before it enters the red blood cell, so in the liver. So what happens is that this protozoite will multiply and change to merozoite, then they will rupture and burst the liver cell. That's why some that have malaria, when you study in pathophysiology, you notice that they'll start saying that the person has yellow eyes, jaundice, liver, elevation of liver enzyme because of this stage. Next. So this merozoite will burst from the liver cell, then they will not infect the red blood cell. Take a photo. So after they infect the red blood cell, what happens is that in the red blood cell, the merozoite will change to trophozoite. And you can see it looks like a ring. What happens is that the trophozoites can either multiply to produce new merozoites that will infect other red blood cell. You know, that's why, you know, malaria causes sepsis or dropping blood pressure, because it's bursting both your liver cell and your red blood cell. So the trophozyte can either multiply and, you know, change back to merozoite. Then the merozoite will also change back to, you know, multiply and turn to trophozyte. Or the trophozyte can, you know, the trophozyte can change to macrogametes and microgametes. Macro is the female, micro is the male. Write that down. So what happens is that after it has done into micro and macrogametes, it will now burst again. So what did I tell you? The merozoite can either, when the merozoite infects the red blood cell, it will change to trophozyte after multiplying. So the trophozyte can either form micro and macrogametocytes or form more merozoites. So these macrogametes and macrogametes is what the mosquito will now take when they bite us again. Then the mosquito, it will now fuse and form sporozoites. You get the cycle. So yeah, that's all. And then the four types of malaria: vivax, ovale, falciparum, and malaria. So that's the end of the lecture. The examination of a patient showed that he has toxoplasmosis. What do you use for diagnosis? Blood. A woman gave birth to a dead baby with a lot of failures of development. What protozoa will cause this? Did I not explain this? That when a woman, you know, is pregnant and she gets toxoplasmosis, she'll give birth to a deformed child. 141. A child was taken to a hospital with complaints of general weakness, pains in the bowels. The physics examined revealed cysts with what? 4 nuclei. What protozoa is this? Of course, it will be Entamoeba histolytica. Why is it not E. coli? Because E. coli has 8 nuclei. You can ask me, why is it not Gardia intestinalis? Because what did they say? Why is it not Gardia intestinalis? Because Gardia intestinalis affect the intestine. I think when they write bowel here, they're talking about, you know, the colon. So I told you, very important. But I see the mom and E. coli, they love the colon side where the plenty shit feces are. 142. Mosquito bites cause the appearance of ulcer on the human skin. The ulcers were observed under microscope. The ulcers content analysis revealed non-flagellated protozoa. What is this? Of course, malaria, because I already told you mosquito. That's the only mosquito we covered now. We did sandfly, kissing bug. It cannot be the leishmaniasis because that's sandfly. It's not scabies, it's not meiosis, so it's malaria. 143. The patient complained of general weakness, bad appetite, nausea. Examination of the duodenal aspirants. Duodenum, what are we thinking? Small intestine. Your mind should be going somewhere to what lambia intestinalis. Then I said 4 pairs of flagella with 2 nuclei. What are we thinking? 4 pairs. Gardiasis or lambia intestinalis, another name. In some region of the world, the cases of malaria become more frequent. What insect is a carrier of malaria? Anopheles mosquito. A patient consulted a doctor because of complaints of general weakness, pain in the bowels, indigestion, bloody diarrhea. Lab analysis showed that the feces contain vegetative form of protozoa with an unstable body shape. Mm-hmm. The cytoplasm contains food vacuum with erythrocytes with red blood cell. What did I tell you here in this photo? See, that was E. coli and E. histolytica. They feed on red blood cell. Okay, and what did they write here? Bowel, again. So, what disease will be Entamoeba histolytica. Why is it not E. coli? I don't know why it's not E. coli, but maybe because, I don't know why, but I guess maybe it's only Entamoeba histolytica that it's red blood cell. I don't think E. coli eats red blood cell. I'm not sure, but yeah, just go for Entamoeba histolytica. If your answer should be Entamoeba coli, they will tell you it's nuclei in the cyst. 146. A patient, so when we reach 150, we'll stop. A patient with bile duct inflammation was admitted to a gastrointestinal department. In the bile content, pear-shaped protozoa with 2 nuclei, 4 pairs of flagella. If you notice, bile, we are towards the small intestine region. Then that's a four pairs of flagella. So what? Giardiasis or lambda intestinalis. Yes? Yes. 146. Yes. 147. A patient with attacks of wasting fever, body temperature 40 degrees, was admitted to the hospital. The attacks repeated rhythmically every 48 hours. It is known from their ministry that the patient has returned from South Africa, where she has been staying for 3 years. What is the causative agent of this disorder? So the answer will be agent of 3 days malaria. Why? Okay, we didn't cover this. I'll come out. I'll do that last. Let's do 148 and 149, then I'll do that. Cysts with 8 nuclei were found in the feces examined through a microscope. What will be the answer? It will be entamoeba coli, because they said cysts with 8 nuclei were found in the feces. Some antelopes were brought to Kiev Zoo from Africa. Trypanosomiasis gambiae were found. So, was found in the antelope's blood. So, sleeping sickness. Are these antelopes epidemically dangerous? Forgive my English is so difficult. God. Of course, the answer will be what? They are not dangerous. Why? We just did the life. No, we did not do the life cycle of cystic fly. It was malaria. But if you do the life cycle of cystic fly, it's not. It is from what? From the cystic fly, because it's Africa, to the human. Then life go. It will like continue. It's not. We didn't talk about, you know, antelope. So that's why it's not dangerous. 50. Have you returned from Turkey, a patient with ulcer on his face came to the doctor. The doctor diagnosed cutaneous leishmaniasis. What do you see? Ulcer on the face, ulcer on the skin. They didn't talk about organs though. What did the doctor diagnose? Cutaneous leishmaniasis. I'm sure if you check these countries around the Asia region, how did the disease get into the patient's organism? So it will be by the inoculable way. Why? Because we just did leishmaniasis, and it's sandfly, bite of sandfly. So it's not sexual contact, it's not food, and it's not direct, and it's not respiratory. So it has to be, when you say to inoculate something, it's to infect something or to bite something. So that's why it's 150. So let's go back to this question here. Here they said the attacks was rhythmically. So I have a question to ask you.